No, this is about as mild a weather and day as you'll get here for NFL football in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Very mild temperatures here in the upper Midwest. 58 degrees at kickoff. Partly cloudy skies. It's about perfect football weather as we get set for the Packers and the Bills. Mike McCarthy, year number five as the Packers head coach. This is first ever head coaching post at any level, high school or the collegiate level. And a guy who really has just the perfect temperament, not only for this franchise, Randy, but for this town as well. Small knit community here in Green Bay.
Absolutely. And this is, you mentioned the weather. Week two, this is really unusual for an NFL player. You can play harder and longer, especially the big guys. There's no IVs at halftime. This is great Fat Man weather.
Ryan Lindell on the kick. Jordy Nelson back deep to return from his own goal line. We're underway here at Lambeau Field. Nelson will cut across. He's out past the 20. Has some room. Finally tripped up. And out to the 35-yard line. It was Reggie Corner, one of the backup Bills cornerbacks, making the tackle. Aaron Rodgers back for year three as the Packers starting quarterback. Not his best statistical day last weekend in Philly, but got it done. Last season, just 7 total interceptions, threw 2 of them last week in that 27-20 win in Philadelphia. Good field position for the Packers to start. Brandon Jackson, whom we mentioned, will split out up at the top of your picture, making his first NFL start since his rookie season back in 2007. Some pre-snap movement defensively from Buffalo. It looks like Rodgers hit as he throws. He completes to Donald Driver. Close to the 45-yard line. Should be enough for the first down. And we'll assume here that the penalty will be against the Buffalo defense. It looked like Kyle Williams came across early.
He got into that neutral zone as the ball was snapped.
Defense number 95 in the neutral zone to snap. Penalties declined. Play results in a first down.
Aaron Rodgers didn't even have to bring out the A-game in the way of the inflection and the hard count. Kyle Williams jumped all by himself just on the quick motion.
Rodgers finding Driver for 13 yards gives the Packers a first and 10 from their own 47-yard line. To Michael Finley, the tight end in motion. Rodgers the give to Jackson. With a stutter step move, gets himself inside Bills territory, close to the 46-yard line. It was Keith Ellison making the defensive stand. Offensively for the Packers, Chad Clifton back for his 11th season for Green Bay. Injury riddled in 09, back healthy. Backs and receivers, Brandon Jackson making his first NFL start in 3 years for the injured Ryan Grant.
Quinn Johnson in 45 is in at fullback and Kuhn 30 is in at tailback.
Quinn Johnson stepping in today for the injured Corey Hall, the Packers' usual starter at the fullback position. This is Kuhn. Kuhn started the season, Randy, as their backup fullback, but getting some more looks now with Ryan Grant done for the season. Buffalo defensively will start up front. Marcus Stroud, the former Pro Bowler with Jacksonville, back for his third season with the Buffalo Bills. Linebackers Keith Ellison stepping in for the injured Paul Posluszny, has started 38 games for Buffalo over his last 4 years and a very good secondary, maybe the best in the NFL, featuring Jarris Byrd, the free safety, 9 interceptions and a Pro Bowl nod as a rookie in 2009. Brandon Jackson lining up in the I formation behind his fullback Johnson. Rodgers, little swing pass for the fullback Johnson. The fourth-year man making his first ever NFL start. I should say his second NFL season. Johnson showing he's got some nice soft hands out of the backfield.
It was a really nice job. Johnson lines up in the backfield. And just a quick little play, not even a play action look per se. That's an old West Coast offense staple. Bring that fullback into the flat, and if he's open, just dump it off to him, let him run with it. Nice job by Johnson, good recognition by Rodgers.
Johnson, the Packers' fifth-round pick back in 2009, making his first NFL start. Played 9 games last season. This is Kuhn again, so it looks like McCarthy, Randy, maybe giving Jackson a chance to get his nerves settling here at the early part of the game.
Also, you're going with the hammer kind of backfield. When you've got a 6-foot, about 250-pound tailback in front of a fullback who's a little bit bigger, and you're Mike McCarthy, you're getting a little attitude working. You're trying to send a message to that defense, they better stop my run. And when you've got an Aaron Rodgers, look out for the play action.
Packers in 2009, third to last in rush yards per game. Trying to establish an early rhythm. here today. Again, Kyle Williams moving early. Rogers slings it end zone. It's incomplete. Trying to find James Jones. Terrence McGee on the coverage. And it looks like Buffalo will be penalized defensively for the second time early in this game.
Here we go, man.
Outside. Defense number 95 in the neutral zone to snap. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
It's a very simple rule. And no one has less of an excuse than Kyle Williams, the nose guard. You're right next to the ball. If the ball doesn't move, you don't move. Don't listen to the quarterback. Don't listen to the lineman's calls. Don't look at the motion. If the ball doesn't move, he can't be offside.
Maybe the center was talking a little trash like Randy Cross back in the day just to get him off rhythm. It's a quick way for Williams to get the early hook. Williams was a Pro Bowl alternate last season. Rogers here. His pass deflected at the line of scrimmage. Incomplete. Linebacker Andre Davis got a hand on it.
Yeah, the thing about this Packer offense, Spiro, when you look at him, you know, and Andre Davis, the linebacker with Buffalo, very experienced at seeing these style of offenses, and he can bring that experience to this defense. Very rhythmic. Very much they're looking for you to make a mistake. They're looking for you to give them a matchup. Aaron Rodgers wants one-on-one. He got it with Jones and missed it.
Randy, Green Bay last season on third downs, the third best team in this scenario in the NFL. We'll see what they do here on third and three from the 27.
Comes the blitz, and he calls a timeout. He's getting a blitz off the slot with Bird.
Well, the early recognition by Aaron Rodgers, he'll burn the Packers' first of three timeouts. Timeout here in Green Bay. Stay with us. Here in Green Bay, Lambeau Field sold out for the Packers' home opener. Early going here at Lambeau. The Packers on their opening drive of the game, a critical third down and three, they call it, from the Buffalo 27-yard line. Rodgers burning a timeout a moment ago, recognizing the blitz was coming. He'll work from the shotgun formation here with John Kuhn lined up to his right.
Same look. Looks like same blitz.
Rodgers has time, lofts it towards the end zone. It's caught, and they say incomplete. Jones makes the catch, but just ran out of room at the 3-yard line. It'll be fourth down.
There's an example of finding your mismatch, finding where you should put the ball, and it was to Jones again, working against Leotis McKelvin.
Randy, we talked to a couple of their secondary guys yesterday, Dante Whitner, Drayton Florence. They were looking forward to this challenge of going up against a guy like Aaron Rodgers. As you see Mason Crosby lining up for the 44-yard kick. Crosby last week, a Packers record 56-yarder in Philadelphia. This one is good from 44 yards out as the Packers manage to salvage 3 points. Now, Chan Gailey and his offense will get their first shot when we come back. Green Bay, the early 3-0 lead. This is the NFL on CBS.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. Viagra. And by Bud Light. It's a sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
Here in Green Bay, the Packers with a nice, long, prolonged scoring drive to start. 8 plays, 40 yards, 3 minutes and 11 seconds. Capped off by that man's field goal from 44 yards out, Mason Crosby. Banged one in from 56 yards, we mentioned earlier, last weekend in Philadelphia. A couple of rookies back deep to return for the Bills. C.J. Spiller and Donald Jones, one of their backup wide receivers. And this is Jones, the young man from Youngstown State, the undrafted first-year player brought down at the Buffalo 19-yard line, Derek Martin. The Packers safety making the stop. It's a return of 18 yards. There is Trent Edwards coming onto the field, getting some final instruction from his head coach. Edwards, really, for many people, a make-or-break year, Randy, as an NFL starter. Certainly didn't bowl anyone over with the stats last weekend. Granted, did not throw a pick. Didn't make the big mistake, but they need him to start taking some shots down the field.
Well, Spiro, he originally got the job because J.P. Lossman threw the ball down the field but would ignore everything underneath. Now he can't make anybody happy because he won't press the ball down the field, and all he does is throw the ball underneath.
And a little wrinkle here from Chan Gailey. He'll go Marshawn Lynch, Pro Bowler a couple of years ago. He's been really the lost man in the running back mix early on for Buffalo, brought down by A.J. Hawk. who already has played one more defensive snap than he did all of last weekend. Buffalo offensively, Cornell Green at right tackle, their lone new addition to the starting offensive front. A free agent signee over the offseason. Backs and receivers, Lee Evans, Buffalo still their best offensive player, but his 2009 numbers leaving something to be desired. And really some thinly veiled comments this week directed at his quarterback, getting a little bit impatient with this conservative offense. Second down and long. They call it eight. That's Marshawn Lynch again, and boy, he's got nowhere to go. Barely gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Let's look at how the Packers will line up defensively. Up front, Cullen Jenkins at one of the defensive end positions, playing with a broken hand today that he sustained in the win last week in Philadelphia. Linebackers, A.J. Hawk at the inside position. But did not play a single snap, as we mentioned, was very unhappy about that, voicing his displeasure in the Packers secondary. Charles Woodson, the NFL's reigning defensive player of the year, like a fine wine, getting better with age now, 33.
Jenkins is the only D lineman on the field. He's over the center at nose tackle. Everybody else a linebacker or a DB.
Edwards here on third and eight. Pocket collapses, and guess who? It's Clay Matthews. Had three sacks last weekend, ruining Philadelphia's offense, and an inauspicious start for the Bills. It's a loss of 13 yards, and the Bills will punt deep from their own end zone.
Well, this is the view that Edwards had. He's looking at all kinds of blitzes. It ended up being a zone blitz. Two of the three linebackers on the field, one of which was Mr. Matthews, came on the blitz, and Cullen Jenkins, everybody else dropped.
Brian Moorman dealing with a back injury this week, did not practice on Friday, is here pinned into his own end zone, barely gets it away. Packers will signal for the fair catch. Tremont Williams, their backup cornerback, no, he'll pick it up. It appeared as though he had signaled for the fair catch as Williams runs himself out of bounds very close to midfield. So Rodgers, another chance when we come back. His Packers with a 3-0 lead. Tomorrow on The Late Show, don't miss former President Bill Clinton. And Wednesday, Joaquin Phoenix returns on an all-new day. That'll be followed by Craig Ferguson. Only CBS.
Green Bay picked up not only the points, but then their defense picked them up some yards on this next possession. This is one of those offenses you don't want to give an edge. You don't want to give them an advantage, because then you're going to turn this defense even more loose. Then they'll take more chances and they'll blitz at you even more.
Brandon Jackson lines up in the I formation, set in front of his fullback Quinn Johnson, with Rodgers under center on first and 10 from the Buffalo 49-yard line. Rodgers has time, finds Donald Driver, trying to with some room to maneuver out of bounds close to the Buffalo 40-yard line.
See, with the personnel that they do, and you see in and out of the field, you're constantly going to see players running on and off the field. The natural question still going into this game is, what are they missing without Ryan Grant, Spiro? And it's significant. It's power. It's grinded kind of running. But right now they're replacing it with personnel and packages.
Grant going down, tearing a tendon in his ankle. With an ugly-looking play last weekend in Philadelphia. Rodgers going play action, rolling right, has all day to throw, and there is the big, burly tight end, Jermichael Finley. First down yardage and much more down to the Buffalo 10-yard line.
Well, a beautiful play concept by the Green Bay Packers. Roll right, coming from the backside right there, Jermichael Finley, after the snap. He rolls the same way as Aaron Rodgers, drags all the way across the defense. He's the one play. Philadelphia double-teamed him from the get-go. We've seen a lot of double teams so far out of Buffalo. Here, they're letting him run free across the zone. You could never let that guy run free across the zone.
Finley, 34 yards through the air last season. Just an incredible 2009 performance, giving this Green Bay team a vertical threat at tight end that they just have not had really, since the mid-1990s, Randy and Keith Jackson. As Rodgers keeps it on the ground on first down to Brandon Jackson. Oh, we mentioned Ryan Grant and what he has brought to this Green Bay offense. 1,200 yards each of the last 2 years. It's amazing. This guy is still underappreciated by many fans, Randy, in this area. Never fumbled last season, and the guy never has missed a game due to injury.
The advantage that I think anyone following Ryan Grant really has, though, this offense is so diverse. It spreads so much. There'll be a lot of field for Brandon Jackson to run in because you're so worried about the offensive weapons.
Second and goal, they call it here from the Buffalo 6. Here's Rodgers throwing end zone. It's nearly intercepted. Dangerous looking throw by Rodgers, who threw two picks last weekend in Philly. His intended receiver was Finley, the tight end.
Well, that's exactly what Dante Whitner was talking about, that Aaron Rodgers has so much confidence in his chemistry with JerMichael Finley. Sometimes he puts it where the ball doesn't belong. And there's a gift-wrapped opportunity to go about 97 yards for a touchdown right in his hands that Whitner did not take advantage of.
Rodgers, all of last season, threw just two multi-interception games.
Worst against a bad team in Tampa, ironically.
This is third and goal. Buffalo showing blitz. Rodgers from the shotgun. Rolling out. Pump faking. Throws end zone. It's incomplete. Batted down. James Jones was the intended receiver. It was Keith Ellison, the man who's filling in today for Paul Posluszny, defending the pass.
You have to know if you play defense against Aaron Rodgers in this offense, he has such confidence in his arm and in his receivers. See, James Jones is covered. He is absolutely covered. But Ellison has to wrap all the way around and knock that one away because Rodgers still tried to fit that in going away.
Well, Mason Crosby has been Mr. Automatic from inside the 40 since 2006. Here bangs it in from 24 yards out. As Buffalo's defense again doing its job, giving up just 3 points to this vaunted Aaron Rodgers offensive attack. 6-0 Green Bay.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Sprint, the Now Network, and by McDonald's. I'm loving it.
A couple of Mason Crosby field goals. The difference in where we stand. You see the Green Bay scoring drive, 6 plays, 43 yards. The Buffalo holding its ground defensively, desperately trying to give Trent Edwards some breathing room early in this game and some hope as the Bills try to turn their offense around. This is C.J. Spiller, the rookie from Clemson. Maybe the fastest player already in the NFL, forced out of bounds close to the Buffalo 30-yard line. Randy, you just talked about it during the break. Green Bay defensively is going to dare Buffalo to try to hurt them with their ground game. So far, certainly have not looked very scary in that department.
And at home, keep track of that or lack of respect of the running game by Mike McCarthy and the Green Bay Packers by how many defensive linemen they put on the field. If they're in their standard 3-4 and there's three big guys out there, great. But if you see two defensive linemen inside or even just one defensive lineman, they're saying we can stop you with linebackers and we'll rush you with everybody else.
And Chan Gailey continues to go with Marshawn Lynch at his starting running back position here. And this is Lynch on the take. This time has some room out past the 35-yard line up to the 36. Lynch in the news this week. We mentioned he has been really the lone man out of the running back mix early. There were rumors that Green Bay would be interested, Randy, with the injury to Ryan Grant, but Buffalo and Green Bay both saying that's not the case.
And a kind of a throwaway line by Aaron Rodgers. He played with him in college, and the comment he made to us on Friday was, hey, last time I played with this guy, he averaged 9 yards a carry. Why wouldn't I want to play with him?
Injured Buffalo lineman. It's Andy Levitre on the field, the second-year man. We'll take a break.
You're watching the NFL on CBS.
Well, something the Buffalo offense can ill afford, any more injuries to their offensive line. Andy Levitre looked like may have suffered a stinger on that last play, Randy, something that I'm sure you felt it one or two times in your career.
Well, he was trying to block Clay Matthews. He can have that effect on offensive linemen.
Green Bay showing blitz on second down. Edwards, play action. Hit as he throws and he goes down. Cullen Jenkins, broken hand and all, wrapped him up, and Clay Matthews there as well.
Clay Matthews might be having an appeal to the stat man because that's why Trent Edwards had to move up in a base 3-4. We talked about substitution. Well, they didn't do any, but here comes 52. you got to move up to try to get away. And that ran him right into the big fellow's arms, right into Cullen Jenkins, where he just gets swallowed. Excellent team defense.
But Matthews has become the poster boy for guys who don't want to go to training camp and play well. Matthews missed 29 days of camp. Showed up last week in Philly, 9 tackles, 3 sacks, and he's got 2 already here today. Third down, Edwards pass in and out of the hands of Fred Jackson, and Buffalo once again go 3 and out, and they'll have to punt.
Not much. They dropped right off. You saw personnel-wise, they had 2 defensive linemen and Matthews coming after Edwards. No pressure on Edwards, but there was absolutely nobody open. And right now, this Buffalo offense just looks flat, flustered.
Randy, the easy thing is to take shots at Trent Edwards and say the guy just hasn't been able to show down the field ability. You got to give the guy some time to throw the football. Here's Brian Moorman, booted a 51-yarder on his first attempt. Tremont Williams catches from his own 21-yard line. Williams trying to cut back, is wrapped up and brought down at the 27-yard line. And that is where Aaron Rodgers and the Packers will take over. 49-yard punt and a return of 5 yards. 6-0 here in Green Bay. Green Bay is 6-0 lead. Gives us a chance to get into our crossword segment. Randy, what do you have for us?
You always hear us talk about gaps. Well, we're going to look at gaps from the defensive side instead of the offensive side. Between the center and the guard, that's the A gap. This is the B gap between the guard and the tackle. And if we had tight ends on both sides, that would be the C gap. Again, that's lettered from the defensive side of the ball. Offense always uses numbers. There's Dom Capers. Boy, is his 3-4 defense taken to the Green Bay Packers and vice versa.
18th season in the NFL as either a head coach or a defensive coordinator. Dialing it up early today. That's Brandon Jackson for the Packers on 1st and 10. Getting close to the original line of scrimmage.
And we spoke a little bit, Spiro, earlier about the confidence of the secondary of the Buffalo Bills, and they were looking forward to the challenge. And you really have to man up against this Green Bay offense because of what they can throw at you. Just look at the receivers. Look at a Jermichael Finley, who's the tight end. He's 6'5", 245. Then you still have Donald Driver, who never seems to get old.
Donald Driver, the ageless one, still making it happen. As they complete here right on cue, 2 Driver, the 3-time Pro Bowl selection. Drayton Florence, a fear cornerback, making the tackle, and it's a 1st down for the Packers.
And Driver lined up in the right slot. You had inside, so then you have 3 defensive backs for 2 receivers. And once you stress down the field, Donald Driver's going to cover you a little bit underneath, but Jennings is the guy they worry about getting behind him.
Donald Driver, 6 consecutive 1,000-yard seasons for Green Bay. Rodgers giving to Dimitri Nance, the young man who was signed off the Falcons practice squad this week. Nance, the rookie free agent out of Arizona State, just 22 years of age, arrived here in Green Bay on Tuesday morning. And has worked extensively this week with running backs coach Edgar Bennett trying to get the playbook down. Boy, that's a tough sell and a tough thing to do in the span of about 5 days.
But the NFL's so much about packages. You hear that from offensive and defensive people that every single time you talk to them. You can do that. Dimitri Nance probably has a 10 or 12 play package to run.
Green Bay already has given the football to 4 different running backs on the day. This is Brandon Jackson. Jackson close to the 1st down marker. We had a chance to sit down with Brandon on Friday. Such a likable kid, 24 years of age. And you think back, Randy, to 2007. This was the running back of the future, at least for 3 to 4 months. He came in as a rookie, started from day one, then was lost due to injury. And then Ryan Grant came in, took the job, and never relinquished it.
He chooses to look at it as he's getting the same opportunity he had at Nebraska. Started early there, had to sit out for a couple years. Or a year and a half, and now he's back here to reclaim his spot in his mind.
3rd down and 2, Rodgers works from the shotgun formation from the Green Bay 47. Rodgers lofting it inside the 30, it's caught by Finley. Jermichael Finley, such a vertical threat at the tight end position. more than enough for the first down. It's a 32-yard pass play.
We spoke of mismatches, and the mismatch is on your right. Kelce, former defensive end, now a strong side backer, number 90. You've got him matched up on man-on-man with JerMichael Finley. You might as well put a nose tackle on him.
That can't be.
I'm not ripping Chris Kelce. That's just an impossible task.
That can't be what George Williams had in mind, the Buffalo defensive coordinator. So 32 yards, Rodgers to Finley. Gives the Packers a first and 10 from the Buffalo 20. John Kuhn lines up with the running back position. Rodgers play action. Pass sailing low, incomplete, intended for Brett Jennings. And that'll make it second down. I should say George Edwards, the defensive coordinator. That cannot be how he envisioned it defensively coming into this game.
You know when you're a Green Bay, though, Spiro, is that teams have to take chances against you.
Second and 10 from the
and Coach Edwards knows you've got to pick your spots, and sometimes you're going to get a bad matchup because their base personnel is a bad matchup waiting to happen. You gamble, you roll those dice. They came up snake eyes for him that time.
Edwards in Miami the last couple of seasons as the Dolphins linebackers coach. Trying to thwart this Green Bay offensive attack. Rodgers on second down, throwing up high. It's caught, and now they say incomplete. James Jones at the 3-yard line. Well, let's see what the ruling is. They do say he was out of bounds, and it's incomplete. We'll see if McCarthy wants to take another look. Jones making the catch.
That's a beautiful kind of back shoulder throw, but the right foot comes down right on the line. Watch the right foot of Jones up. Down from the other angle, you could see the white paint better, but he was out of bounds. I think that was a very good call. There's two officials doing a beautiful job of working in conjunction. As the foot comes down, watch it right there. That right foot came down out of bounds. The side of that right foot was on white paint, I believe.
Mike McCarthy looking up at the Jumbotron inside the stadium, looking at the exact same replay that we were.
Yeah, there's dozens of thousands of impartial judges here, right?
You know what they wanted him to do. As McCarthy throws out the red challenge flag, and they'll take another look. Clock stopped at 2:24 to play first quarter. Green Bay, a couple of Mason Crosby field goals, the difference. Holding a 6-0 lead, we'll take another look.
Again, the right foot. Now watch the right paint, the white paint. There's the foot. Now when it comes all the way down is when it rolls. And when it rolls, right there. Now you stop it right there. There's no doubt in your mind that that is out of bounds. That's a third of a foot. And I don't mean a 12-inch foot. I mean a foot.
Yes.
As far as, you know, if he wore a single A instead of a double D, that might be in, or triple E's in the case of the white feet like me, but just got too much foot on the right side of it there that hits that white paint. I don't see where this is a great challenge.
That's a tough position for a head coach to be in. Doesn't have, obviously, a video monitor to look at. He's got to peer up with the rest of the 60,000 or so plus here at Lambeau Field for the replay, and really just goes on a hunch. And the key is here, Randy, the call on the field is incomplete. So now they must have conclusive video evidence to overturn. I'm not sure they do.
Right. But I really want to emphasize the look of the two officials. You notice the official on the right, he's right there. Official at the bottom of the screen, they work in conjunction. Now there's a good example of teamwork of the officials, because what one guy can't see from his angle, the other guy can from his.
After review. Ruling on the field is confirmed. The receiver landed with his right foot on the sideline. Therefore, it is an incomplete pass. Green Bay is charged with a team timeout.
So Mike McCarthy and the Packers will be charged with the timeout. Green Bay had to use one earlier, so they're down to just one.
10 from the 20.
With still 2:24 left to play in this first quarter. The total offense in this game hasn't even been close. 130 for Green Bay. The Bills, meantime, negative 14. Third down at Buffalo 20. Rodgers from the... Rodgers feeling the pressure. Keeps it himself inside the 10. And he'll slide down to the 5-yard line. And in the process, picks up another Packers first down.
Very nice job by Aaron Rodgers of feeling the coverage. They're in man. Man means players are running away from him. That leaves all that open area in front of him. Hey, on that second down, too, with the catch or non-catch by James Jones, remember the play was, or the rule was changed about force outs a while back. If it appeared, used to be if you appeared like you'd come in inbounds, you'd get that.
No more. As Rodgers picks up 12 yards here, they give to Jackson on first down. Jackson trying to bowl his way inside the five. And brought down after a pickup of 2 yards. Jackson, 24 years of age, his fourth NFL season from Nebraska. Kept his two young children at home, has an 8-year-old son, Brandon Jr., his daughter Braylon, 18 months, says she's been a handful trying to keep her settled at home to get some extra sleep this week.
Well, he's going to be on an offense that's going to keep Buffalo up here in the red zone. Look at the bunch left. Now you get a little motion coming at you with Jones.
Jackson, the lone setback on second down and goal from the 6. Rodgers completes to Jones inside the 5, lunging to the 1.
Rodgers pass complete to James Jones.
As we come up now on 50 seconds left in the first, Terrence McGee the tackle after Jones picks up 4.
You had Jermichael Finley on the outside, 88. He suddenly turns into a blocker. Simple assignment. Beat McGee, 24, the corner. That's Jones's job, but McGee does a beautiful job of coming up, closing, and if you're a young corner, that's how you tackle a wide receiver in open space.
Randy, we touched on Green Bay's prowess as a third down team already, 3 of 5 today. This is a third and goal from just inside the... There's Jackson, cutting back close to the goal line. Touchdown, Green Bay.
Brandon Jackson's been waiting to do that as a starter for a while. Do the Lambeau leap. He could drag Mr. Kuhn, his fullback, up there with him because that was a beautiful lead block leading the way.
Packers, keep in mind, playing without their usual starting fullback, Corey Hall. A late stretch by Mike McCarthy as Crosby's point after is through, and Green Bay builds on its lead. Brandon Jackson, his first NFL start in 3 years, has given the Pack a 13-0 lead. All Green Bay here at the start, leading the Bills 13-0. Fans, if your fantasy football site is letting you down, there's still time to upgrade to the award-winning Fantasy Football Commissioner. Get a special offer and help moving your league at cbssports.com/upgrade.
Got some early points out of Brandon Jackson if you decided to pick him up this week and play him.
Well, he was the popular pickup around the country. Thousands, millions of fantasy leagues around the country. Green Bay scoring drive, 11 plays, 72 yards, 5 minutes and 37 seconds. And nothing like a little Lambeau leap to help settle those nerves as Jackson celebrates with about 1,000 of his closest friends.
Buffalo has to do something. Couple first downs, anything on offense right now.
They've got negative 14 yards so far in the day. This is Spiller, and boy, he is met by a green wall at the 18-yard line. 16 yards on the return. Donald Lee got there first for the tackle.
C.J. Spiller is a guy that you always will hear the term throughout his career. But, man, when you get him in air, he can do wonders. Well, you get him in air, it's full of green. Obviously, he doesn't do quite as much, huh?
Spiller among the most prolific running backs in college football history. Had a rough go of it last weekend at home against Miami. And so far, we have not seen much of him on first and second down for Buffalo. It's been Marshawn Lynch, the workhorse in this first quarter. First and 10, Edwards giving to Lynch. Running right, Lynch has the first down and more. This little spin move to get himself to the 33-yard line. And as we have reached the end of the first quarter here in Green Bay, Lynch picking up 14 yards. Buffalo, however, down 13-0. Well, so far, as expected, it has been a one-sided affair here in Green Bay for the Packers' home opener. They lead the Bills 13-0 as we start quarter number two. Spiros Dinas, Randy Cross, our entire CBS crew. Buffalo has it after picking up their first down of the day on a Marshawn Lynch 14-yard run play. Here is Lynch again up to the 38-yard line for Buffalo.
You know, Spiro, if you're a hardcore football fan, I guess you've got two questions watching this thing right now, especially if you're a Buffalo fan. A is, where's Lee Evans? Are they triple-teaming him? Well, they have been giving him some interesting coverages. Two is Buffalo featuring Marshawn Lynch here early? Is it a trade thing?
Maybe showcasing, like you see in baseball and some of the other sports. Marshawn Lynch coming into today listed as the third string running back, but so far he's been the number one guy in this game. Lynch again here, second down at about five, trying to stutter step his way past the 40 and out to the 41-yard line. Right now we get it to New York and an update and James Brown.
Spiro and Randy, after rookie Dez Bryant put the Cowboys up 7-3 with a 62-yard punt return. Quick strike back from Chicago. Jake Cutler to the tight end Greg Olsen, 39 yards to pay dirt. Bears nursing a three-point lead in the second over the Cowboys. Spiro and Randy.
Boy, can you imagine Jerry Jones on a Monday morning after the Cowboys would go to 0-2 if they can't win that game?
Wasn't Mike Martz the guy that doesn't throw to tight ends?
Different story. Olsen a big play. Chicago the 10-7 lead. Edwards on third down finding Spiller, and this is where you want this player out in the open field on a third down as the Bills now starting to show some life, pick up their second first down.
Very important. They got that 14-yard play. They got to zero. Now they get a C.J. Spiller in a comfort zone because this is how he ran in Clemson. They line him up in the slot. They put him out in motion out of the backfield. They line him up at wide receiver. And I think you'll see eventually Chan Gailey and company will move him into the same kind of spots.
Spiller picks up seven through the air. Buffalo desperately trying to find some points. Lynch on the take from Edwards inside Green Bay territory, close to the 48-yard line. Tackled by Nick Barnett after Lynch picks up 3 yards.
Well, a big thing to consider after a first quarter, and we talked about the yards and whatnot, but just flat plays. First quarter, Green Bay ran 23 plays. Buffalo ran 7. If I'm on that Buffalo defense, I'm seeing exactly what I want to see out of my offense short of points right here. Hold on to the ball, get a little methodical, get some rhythm going, and keep your defense off the field for a little while.
This is a Green Bay defense that ranked number one in the NFL against the run last season. Nice spin move by Lynch. Another Buffalo first down. Boy, if they're showcasing him, that's one thing. Probably some NFL teams very impressed, starting with his own head coach, Chan Gailey.
Lynch does a beautiful job of spinning. And then down the field, Hangartner, his center, watch 63 come through here. That's just a very, very nice job of not giving up on the run. Not assuming there's going to be a tackle. Everyone around Marshawn Lynch blocking, and Chan Gailey's offense has got a little bounce to it right now.
So Lynch picks up 11 more yards. He's got 8 carries and 42 yards so far. Fred Jackson into the game. Edwards slings it deep down the field. Evans is brought down and tackled by Woodson. And that's an easy call for the officials to make. And now Buffalo really has something working offensively.
There's Lee Evans. You know, it doesn't hurt to sometimes throw it down the field because sometimes you get this kind of effect. It draws a flag and you get a long play.
Defense number 21. Penalizes the spot of the foul and a first down.
Even if it is against one of the all-time greats. And Charles Woodson will go down as one of those corners. But look at the right hand. He's got Evans's left arm hooked. And when he falls down, he pulls Evans to the ground.
Well, Evans making those very subtle remarks this week to the press in Buffalo, saying that at some point, we need to take some shots down the field. And Edwards, to his credit, does right there, and it pays huge dividends. As the pass interference penalty gives the Bills a first and 10 from the Green Bay 13-yard line. Is Fred Jackson on first down inside the 10 and finally brought down at the 4-yard line. So the penalty was 24 yards and then Jackson gets him closer with 9 yards on first down.
Well, we showed you in the very open of the game the kind of potential this running back trio of Buffalo has. You've seen the power of Lynch. You've seen now a little bit of power and wiggle coming out of Jackson. You've seen Spiller catch that thing coming out of the backfield. Great drive right now for Buffalo. Nice confidence. They have to get a touchdown. In order to be here in the right spot to stay right here with the Packers, Chan Gailey's team needs 6.
Randy, some confusion with his personnel group, and Gailey on his first time out as Buffalo working 14-0. A reminder to stay tuned for the Sprint Halftime Report. You can join JB, Dan Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cower for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. It's all coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Now, Buffalo just 5 total yards in the first quarter, finally showing some life. They've got it first and goal from the Green Bay 4. Here is Jackson sprinting out to the left. Waltz is in. Touchdown, Buffalo.
Perfect drive for Buffalo. Keeps the defense off the field, puts points on the board. Look at McIntyre, 38 out in front. He just slices Charles Woodson down to the ground. That was perfectly executed by the left side of that Buffalo offense.
Ryan Lindell on for the point after attempts. And the Buffalo Bills looking dead in the water early in the game, had nothing going offensively, down 13-0. They've answered back. 8 plays, 80 yards. Jackson from 3 yards out.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by KFC. Football fans, today is the day you double down. So good. The all-new CRZ Sport Hybrid, only from Honda. And by FedEx. We understand. You need a winning game plan. FedEx.
Green Bay 13, Buffalo 7. Bills scoring drive, 8 plays, 80 yards in 4 minutes, 22 seconds. And for the first time in 5 quarters this season, make it 6 quarters, the Bills were in the red zone. This is Jordy Nelson fielding from his own 15-yard line. Nelson cutting back across the field, out past the 30 to the 35, and finally forced out of bounds at the Green Bay 40. A 27-yard return by Jordy Nelson. Well, Buffalo desperately trying to stay within striking distance. Fred Jackson from 3 yards out. Buffalo down 6. So much for Buffalo trying to thwart that Green Bay momentum. They punch it in on a touchdown, and then they allow Jordy Nelson 27 yards on the return. An excellent field position for Aaron Rodgers and company to start. Brandon Jackson, the lone setback on first and 10 from their own 40. Rodgers, little bubble screen, finding Greg Jennings, who loses yards. Brought down to the 37-yard line, lost 2 yards. Randy, we just talked about the average starting field position has been all Green Bay. They just can't afford to continue in this direction.
And the whole idea here with this stat down at the bottom, the hidden yardage, it's pretty simple to explain. If Mike McCarthy gets the ball on the 20, drives it down, punts it to you, you get it on your 20. When you punt it back and you change possessions, your field position, your starts, drive starts, gets better and better when you're plus 48 like that, plus 42.
Buffalo already at a disadvantage with how good this Green Bay offense is as they give it to Jackson on second down, trying to fight his way to the original line of scrimmage. Now, this is something that the average fan usually doesn't pay too much attention to during the game, but you can bet that McCarthy and Gailey are talking about the hidden yardage, but a plus 42 coming into this drive favoring Green Bay.
That's an advantage of 14 yards every time Mike McCarthy's offense has had it. That's where you get that 42 yards, and that puts Chan Gailey and the defense at a distinct disadvantage when you start getting the ball further and further up the field like this where they're starting these drives.
A pre-snap movement on both sides. Darren College went early for Green Bay. Here's Ron Winter.
Offense number 73. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
college, they're a very durable left guard. He's never missed a game at the college or NFL level. 121 consecutive games played, called for the false start.
And part of the complaints from a veteran, like a College, like a Tauscher, like a Clifton in these situations, it's not always about the guy moving. They're used to the fact that defensive players move. What they usually complain about an official about, is when the defensive players start barking out things that sound like a signal, making players move.
Got enough to worry about as an offensive lineman. So Rodgers here on third down and 15. Out of the shotgun formation. Rodgers flushed. Rolling right. Throwing. Incomplete. Jones lunging out of bounds. Had it for an instant and lost it. And the Packers will punt.
Well, James Jones got out there on the sideline trying to come back to his quarterback. That quick little slip. Doesn't take much. Just threw his focus off. Because normally these Packer receivers know that Aaron Rodgers doesn't ease the ball in. He zips it like their old guy Brett Favre used to do it, and they're used to catching bullets.
I'll tell you what, your buddy George Edwards has to be very pleased so far with that Buffalo defense.
Get the ball at the 40 and punt. That's perfect.
First punt today for Tim Maste in Green Bay. Roscoe Parrish fielding from his own 27. Signals for the fair catch. And that's where Edwards and Buffalo will take over. First and 10. So the Bills down 13 earlier, now with a chance. Down 6. Stay with us.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by DirecTV. Watch your favorite team wherever you live. Only on DirecTV. Call to switch today. And by Bing. Stop searching, start deciding with Bing, the decision engine from Microsoft.
Well, Mike McCarthy has all the support he needs here in Green Bay. This is the site on Lombardi Drive, just outside the field. And if you live on Lombardi Drive, you may as well have that 20-foot replica statue of the Lombardi Trophy.
And that's the trust part. They trust in McCarthy to deliver one of those.
They take their football very seriously here in Green Bay. That much we certainly know. Here is Marshawn Lynch on first down. Lynch has been the guy so far, his ninth carry, approaching 50 yards already. Now, Buffalo Randy finally starting to show some signs of offensive life.
Well, last week, 14 runs. So far in this game, they've got an even dozen and growing. And the reason you keep running the ball, and you run the ball early, is you get that kind of success. Your offensive line is getting some excellent blocking. And you've got some backs that have the power and the wiggle to take advantage of the holes they're blocking.
And the other thing you have to like is that everyone has been involved, at least from the running back position. Spiller, a couple of chances on third down. Here's Edwards on second down, completes to his man Parrish, close to the 45-yard line. Parrish, not the biggest target on this Bills team at just 5'10", but picks up 13 yards.
Yeah, we talk about a C.J. Spiller and his wiggling ability out in air. You know, Roscoe Parrish is one of the best punt returners we've seen in this league for quite a while. And you'd have to go out of your way when you play him on the offense. You've got to create opportunities for him to get the ball like a returner. That's not like a returner, but get him also the ball in the air. He'll make people miss.
First down play for Parrish at Buffalo's long touchdown last weekend in the loss against Miami. First and 10, Edwards backed up, flushed out. Barely gets it out in time to no one in particular. And we'll see what the call is here. There is no marker thrown. And Edwards looked like he's shaken up. It was Clay Matthews who laid the smack on the Buffalo quarterback.
Yeah, it's going to be an intentional grounding on Edwards. Because he knew the smack was coming. He knew that wasn't just pressure. He was about to take a shot.
There is Ryan Fitzpatrick. Trying to get the blood flowing. Looks like Edwards is okay.
Now the big problem he has, and yes, it went past the line of scrimmage. Yes, 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 all the above. But he never really gets out of the tackle box. He never really escapes that pressure zone and just dumps it over the middle. And there is no one even close to being there. And he takes a pretty nice little 1-2 for it, too.
It's a little Trent Edwards sandwich. At Lambeau Field, Barnett and Matthews crunching the Bills quarterback.
So not only the yards, but also the down on an intentional
grounding. So now we're at second down.
Second and 20 from the 33. Here is Lynch up close to the 40. Still about 14 yards short of the first down marker. Lynch picks up 7.
But you've got the ball in a decent spot. Remember, the Packers got that last kickoff, and Jordy Nelson got it to the 40, and Chan Gailey's defense had to work from there. Now, worst-case scenario, don't do anything bad with the ball. Don't do anything dumb with the ball. Don't expose it to a turnover, because you may just be able to pin Green Bay back and get back some of that hidden yardage.
We've got a pretty good punter in Brian Moorman, who's already kicked one 51 yards. Third down, they find Spiller out of the backfield. Spiller out past the 45, dances back, but is tripped up at the 47. And well short of the first down marker, Brad Jones makes the tackle after Spiller picks up 7.
So there's a very nice job, very nice play call by Buffalo. Green Bay rallied to the ball, did their job. Now they forced a punt by Chan Gailey. Where can Moorman get the ball back? Remember the last possession for Green Bay on the 40-yard line? How many yards further back are you going to press them? How much more field are you going to give your team, your defense, to defense?
Moorman, the elder statesman of this Buffalo team, 34 years of age, punting here to Tremont Williams, who signals for the fair catch at the 15-yard line. So Buffalo winning the battle of field position here in the second quarter, a 37-yard punt. Well, if you love to laugh this fall, there's more to love with the new comedy Mike and Molly. It premieres tomorrow after 2.5 Men, only CBS. Here at Lambeau Field, Spiro Ditas, Randy Cross, our entire CBS crew with you. Boy, what a difference first to the second quarter and since. Buffalo down at 1 point, 13 to nothing, now having the Packers offense pinned back at their own 15.
25 yards further back than last time they had the ball. Can they take advantage of it and force another punt?
We move just under 6 minutes to play before halftime. This is Brandon Jackson. Jackson out to the 20, picks up 3 yards.
And when you think about it, for Mike McCarthy's offense, you know, Brandon Jackson's not being asked to get 1,200 yards in the first 4 or 5 weeks here. This is an offense that will give a running back plenty of opportunities. But Mike McCarthy is so creative, and his coaches do a beautiful job from a personnel standpoint and a formation standpoint to put pressure on a defense. You don't have to jam this ball down people's throat running ball.
McCarthy sends out John Kuhn at the running back position. Rodgers gives to Kuhn. Close to the 25-yard line, a couple of yards short of the first down marker. Chris Kelce, the outside linebacker, making the tackle after Kuhn picks up 4 yards.
And Spiro, here's one of those situations. If you're George Edwards over there in the staff on the defensive side, you would rather not be in. You know, you don't want to have the ball and have them starting on the 40-yard line, and you don't want very many third and two. Because third and two against this offense can get kind of ugly. Because they've got the ability to make third and two a big play.
So Michael Finley in motion. And it looks like Rodgers audibilizes at the line of scrimmage. Rodgers. Incomplete. Intended for Kuhn. It was Kelce on the coverage, and Green Bay will punt. Boy, Rodgers is hot.
I think he kind of went the wrong way. Out to the right was where Kuhn was. He moved. He had Jones and Finley over on the left side. I think he might have missed himself an open receiver, sort of predetermined where he was going to go with that ball. Great job by this Buffalo defense.
So Rodgers, not his best statistical game last weekend in Philadelphia. Today, only 8 of 16 for 110 yards. Now penalty markers flying from multiple directions. There's Tim Maste on the kick. Here's Ron Winter.
Start. Offense number 83. 5-yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
Now, Spiro, remember, and Mike McCarthy and his staff are no doubt very, very well in touch with the fact of who's back there. Now, this is Roscoe Parrish. In the modern era, let's say since the Super Bowl started, this is the best punt returner in average, over 12 yards a punt return, that we've seen in the league.
Maste gets it off from his own 10. Parrish signals for the fair catch. And it will take a Green Bay bounce down to the 31-yard line. 50-yard punt by Maste.
Spiro, an illegal touch. You have a player go out of bounds, cannot be the first player to come in and touch the ball. Even on a down like that, if it's a player that's been out of bounds illegally or out of bounds, he was the first one to touch it, that can't happen. That's why the flag happened.
Illegal touch of the punt. Number 22 from out of bounds. He's the first to come back in and touch the ball. A 5-yard penalty to be assessed at the previous spot. Repeat, fourth down.
That's Pat Lee, one of McCarthy's backup cornerbacks.
And I think he's out of bounds. What do you think? Sparrow, would you call it out of bounds? A little on the white? And no one else, I mean, anyone else on the team touches it, not a big deal.
But you have to say that Lee didn't know the rule.
He kind of, well, I think he wasn't really in touch of what he'd just done. He was more just gotten get down there and reached down and touched it. He just wasn't thinking.
So four penalties already committed by Green Bay. You know, Maste will have to re-kick from his own goal line.
Remember the old days of playing freeze?
Sure.
When you were a kid? Well, he was on freeze. No one unfroze him.
Maste again gets off a good-looking kick. This time, Parrish will take his chances. Inside Green Bay territory, taking on some tacklers. And he's down to the 44-yard line. A marker comes in late. And it comes from the Buffalo side of the field. Clay Matthews says it's against Buffalo.
It's right back through to the middle of the return. That usually means either a hold or a push into the back.
Maste's punt, 45 yards, a 14-yard return by Parrish. As now Ron Winter trying to sort through the call with his colleagues.
George Wilson, he always go with the... You know, me thinks he does protest too much, because usually the guy yelling the loudest is the guy that got the flag thrown on him. If you're not involved, you usually stay away from those guys in the striped shirts.
There are two fouls on the play. During the return, illegal block in the back, number 37 return team. That penalty is declined. During the kick, holding. Return team, 10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. First down.
Well, it's got to drive Chant Gailey just mad. Buffalo starting to really win that field position battle, but the punt will push them back into their own side of the field. Wednesday on Showtime, JB, Chris Collinsworth, Phil Simms, and Warren Sapp return on cable's longest-running show, the multi-award-winning Inside the NFL. It's every Wednesday on Showtime.
And what that penalty really did, the double cost of it, is look where they're starting. You're starting on about the 31-yard line, where you would have been all the way up pretty close to the 50. That's how those yards you've kind of wasted.
Winds up being about a 27-yard penalty against Buffalo. This is Fred Jackson, dances out past the 35, out to the 37. And Buffalo starting to get a good push now, Randy, on first down. Jackson picks up six.
All these spin moves, and you've seen Marshawn Lynch do it, and you've seen Fred Jackson do it, are all fine and good, but you got to be careful doing it against certain styles of defense. I wouldn't suggest it, for instance, against the Pittsburgh Steelers, because they're very gap responsible, very likely when you make that spin, there's going to be a face full of defender right behind you.
See the play calling selection by Gailey in this game. This is Jackson again, close to the 40, about a yard and a half short of the first down mark. Jackson, really Buffalo's feel-good story of 2009 out of Division III Cole College in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. 1,000 yards on the ground, also 1,000 yards in kick returns. And so went down early in training camp, now trying to fight his way back.
And C.J. Spiller just came into the game for Jackson. And I know one thing about CJ, besides his natural ability, he isn't in there to pass block.
Not his forte. So third down and a yard from the 40. End around, and here is Parrish trying to get to the 40. And that little extra burst gets the Bills the first down as Parrish picks up four. That is nifty running by Roscoe Parrish.
Nice substitution. Good play call. The quick little flip was indeed to a C.J. Spiller, and you can't give it to C.J. Spiller on the outside. Give it to Roscoe Parrish coming around and let him go on the other side. Little deception. Not bad blocking. Pretty nice job getting out in front by Cordero Howard.
Buffalo with 8 first downs of the day. 7 coming here in the second quarter. Fred Jackson back into the game, takes the give from Edwards. Wildcat formation set. I should say they pick up 4 yards with Jackson. And we'll take a break. Buffalo on the move, down 6.
Well, the Buffalo offense has done such a nice job of getting their defense some rest. The defense almost looks a little bored on the sideline, Sparrow.
It's been a long time watching Trent Edwards maneuver here. Big play on second down. See some of these statistical numbers. Big discrepancy first and second quarter. Edwards giving to Jackson again. So Jan Gailey, Randy, has taken different turns here. It was Marshawn Lynch early. And now Fred Jackson getting a chance. As we come up on 1:40 to play in this first half, Jackson gets his bell rung, lost his helmet.
And Buffalo has 2 timeouts left. Green Bay's only got 1 in this situation. But Buffalo's in no hurry. They'd rather eat as much of this clock as possible. As far as Chan Gailey's concerned, the clock and having the ball is his friend.
Edwards calling signals, 3rd and 6 from the shotgun. Fires complete inside Packers territory. It's Steve Johnson, a third-year man from Kentucky, but he's well short of the first. And Buffalo will be forced to punt.
Yeah, it was a nice job by Sam Shields playing a little nickelback, coming up and filling and doing a very nice job of knocking the Buffalo receiver quickly to the ground, and at 4th and 2, forcing a punt. A little surprised Green Bay's not stopping the clock here just to give their offense a little bit of more time on the other side.
Packers do have 1 timeout. There is Mike McCarthy looking on, challenged earlier, lost one there.
Didn't do you any good while you're looking at the photos of the defensive looks at halftime, though. Buffalo took that timeout when they let it run down like that. So both teams are at 1 timeout.
So Green Bay, a 13-7 lead, gives us a chance to remind you that coming up, the Sprint Halftime Report, JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cower with all the latest NFL scores and highlights. It's all coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. We're told there are some interesting Week 2 scores around the NFL. Chicago in Dallas, a 17-14 lead at last check. Jerry Jones, no doubt, sweating that one out in his luxury box.
And there was a big cheer here that Miami-Minnesota game. Brett Favre throws a touchdown, and we were an interception. We were in commercial, and the crowd gives it a little cheer.
He's saying they're still a little bitter at Brett Favre here in Green Bay.
Bitter? No. But they'll forget.
Ryan Mormon on departed away. The 34-year-old kicker trying to pin it inside the 5. Cannot. Mormon upset with himself. Will give Green Bay the football after a 48-yard kick at the Packers' 20-yard line. A reminder coming up next. Tom Brady and the Patriots taking aim at Darrell Revis and the Jets, or the Texans tackling the Redskins. Jacksonville also in action, taking on the San Diego Chargers. Check your local listings.
You can't go wrong there.
No, you can't.
I mean, San Diego, I think there won't be any panic. North Turner's got a veteran team, but you lose to Kansas City in that opener. The comfort zone's starting to get squeezed a little bit on that team that figured they'd kind of stroll for the AFC West.
Jets up against it at home. Yes. Tom Brady and the Patriots coming to town. Here is Mike McCarthy's offense, 1st and 10. They'll take no chances. Brandon Jackson. And they'll hear the boos as they come off the field. Boy, what a difference in this game. Randy, Green Bay jumped out to the 13-0 lead, but the Bills right back. It's a 6-point game at the break.
How about the first quarter, second quarter contrast? You've seen the stats. What a big difference.
So that's the end of the first half with Green Bay leading the Bills 13-7. The Sprint Halftime Report is coming up after this message and a word from your local station. Oh, what's a trip to Lambeau Field without a glimpse of that guy. Bart Starr, the Packers Hall of Famer, taking part in Alumni Weekend as the faithful here at Lambeau Field soaking it all in. The home opener for the 2010 Green Bay Packers. Our halftime score from Lambeau Field, the Packers 13 and the Buffalo Bills 7. Spiro Vitas and Randy Cross. Took a while for the Bills to show up, but when they finally did, the offense looked good. The ground game, Randy, last week was a no-show against Miami. Different story today.
That three-headed monster, if you will, that we talked about in the very beginning of this game really has come through for the Buffalo Bills, especially Marshawn Lynch and Jackson have been everywhere. In the second quarter, it was a tale of two quarters. First quarter was amazing for the Green Bay Packers. They looked like they were going to be very rude hosts and treat this Buffalo team rude the whole game, but then Buffalo dominated everything you want to dominate about the second quarter.
And what a contrast in the stats in this game from the first quarter to the second. The teams basically flip-flopping. Buffalo had zero total yards in the first 15 minutes, but then a really reverse in the second quarter. As Randy, you take us through our All-State points of protection.
And this is about as much of a contrast as you'll see in the NFL from one quarter to the other out of teams. I mean, Buffalo had to gain 14 yards on the last play of the first quarter to get up to 0 yards because they were minus 14 going into that last play and then put all those yards up in the second quarter. Green Bay really, passing-wise, was a non-factor in the second quarter. That's what really surprised me the most was the way that Buffalo ratcheted down their pass defense and took away some of the big plays.
Now, we talked about the Buffalo secondary really chomping at the bit. We talked to Dante Whitner, some of their guys yesterday when they got here, the challenge of going against an Aaron Rodgers, something that they have been looking forward to, and they did about as well as you can expect if you're George Edwards going into this game.
Well, especially in that second quarter, and after the game last week in Philadelphia, Aaron Rodgers was not very pleased with his performance, and I guarantee you at halftime he probably was a little tough on himself in evaluation today too, because the passing game, there have been plenty of opportunities and they have not been able to take advantage of all of them.
Mason Crosby on the punt, so Buffalo will return a chance to cut into this deficit and perhaps, dare we say, take a lead. This is C.J. Spiller from his own 4. Spiller, that breakaway ability, getting to the 25-yard line. That's where Trent Edwards and company will take over. A return of 23 yards by the rookie out of Clemson. Trent Edwards, a slow start. Justin Bieber hairstyle, Randy, that he's gone to. We had a chance to talk to his head coach, Chan Gailey, about it. Chan took a beat, paused, and said, we live in a tolerant world these days.
Well, it's, you know, longish. It's a little bit of a Tom Brady Jr. look. Let's put it that way, if you've seen the New England quarterback this offseason.
Well, he's a California guy. It's the new fashionable look on the West Coast. Edwards goes play action, faking to Lynch, completes the pass. They're out past the 30. It's the tight end, Jonathan Stupar, the second-year man from Virginia. Very close to the Buffalo first down.
Well, remember we talked about it early in the first half, about the personnel. And here's defensive lineman. There's only two defensive tackles. And the rest are linebackers. You've got two defensive linemen, you have four linebackers, you have five defensive backs. You shouldn't be outflanked like that with that personnel on the field. Good execution by Buffalo and not that good execution by Green Bay, obviously.
9 yards to Stupar, gives him a second and short from the 34. This is Lynch. Lynch, 10 carries, 52 yards in the first half. And he's picked up a Buffalo first down. And for the first time, Randy, this season, after a very bad offensive day last weekend, we're starting to see Chan Gailey's imprint on this team offensively with a great mix and play caller.
Absolutely. And you look at those possessions in the first half, and that illustrates what we had talked about. Spiro, exactly what you mentioned in the minus 14 in the first two possessions. It looked like it was going to be all Green Bay, but Chan Gailey has been able to dictate a little bit on the offensive side to this Green Bay defense.
This is Gailey's second head coaching stint in the NFL. As Edwards Well, had his man for a moment. It was Steve Johnson, but Johnson takes a big hit by Nick Collins, the safety. And it's ruled incomplete.
Wow, what a beautiful job inside by B.J. Raji and Pickett playing inside, pressing the pocket into Edwards' face and providing this.
A little half-hearted clothesline job by Collins, a very legal defensive play. The two-time Pro Bowler. Pro Bowler, in fact, the last two seasons. Collins had six picks in 2009. Second down, they keep it on the ground to Lynch. Not much room to go for the running back close to the 38-yard line after he picks up 2 yards.
That's as good a reason as any right there that tells you why they're running the ball as much as they are, because they can't pass. Their best pass play was a pass interference on Charles Woodson. Chan Gailey's football team is, at least on this Sunday, light years ahead of the passing game with the running game.
Now, I was going to mention earlier, their passes per attempt last weekend against Miami, 4.1. It's even worse today. But Buffalo only down six. Edwards' pass is through the hands of Johnson, and it's intercepted by Brandon Chiller. And for Trent Edwards, his first interception in 2010.
Green Bay does a very nice job of pressuring Edwards. You got to catch that. There is no excuse, period.
Trent Edwards pass intended for the man on the left of your picture, Steve Johnson, through Johnson's hands and intercepted by Brandon Chiller. That's given the Packers the first possession of the second half inside Bills territory at the 39-yard line. First turnover committed by either team today. This is Rodgers. Has all day to throw. He'll tuck it away, spins his way over the line of scrimmage, and may have picked up a half yard. Randy, when you know Clay Matthews is in the vicinity and is about to lay the wood on you, it could enter your frame of mind.
Watch Johnson will come in from the left side of the screen. Chiller right in the middle over the G. Here comes Johnson, arms out for the ball. Suddenly looks up and sees 52, and the arms get a little shorter. There's no excuse. You want to be a receiver in this league for longer than 3 years? Johnson out of Kentucky. You got to catch those. That's the dangerous kind of work you have to do as a receiver. There's no excuses.
And it really halts some very good work that Edwards was starting to put in with his Buffalo offense. Now the pressure on the Bills' defensive unit to keep them to 3 points at worst as John Kuhn is tripped up at the 36-yard line. Boy, Buffalo's defense has played about as well as they could have hoped. Have held Aaron Rodgers and his vaunted passing attack in check as they pick up just 2 yards. It'll be third down.
Play's designed to be out here on the outside, but it's not designed to have Jairus Byrd be free and get that kind of a tackle on a big physical fullback. 250-pounder, you take him down low below the knees.
Third and seven, Rodgers' long snap count working from the shotgun. And Green Bay very good on third down a year ago. They moved the chains here. Excellent placement by Rodgers throwing behind Jennings. They pick up 17.
A beautiful pickup on the blitz by Kuhn. Get it come out of the slot. A back shoulder throw. A little bit of a push off maybe by Jennings. Maybe. Yeah, it wasn't called. That was definitely a push off. But when you've been in the league a little while, you kind of earned your spots, you've earned your stripes, you're going to get that kind of benefit of the doubt.
Jennings, the 50th man out of Western Michigan, one of the top lone deep threats in the National Football League. Another completion by Rodgers, finding Jordy Nelson this time inside the 10, 11 yards, and another Green Bay first down.
See, that's doing hard work over the middle. There's a young receiver taking the ball, taking the hit. Play before that. He took some chances. George Edwards, the defensive coordinator of Buffalo, brought the blitz off the slot. Fullback picks up the blitz. That buys Aaron Rodgers the time. He throws back shoulder. Then he throws the tough catch. And suddenly now you're inside the 10-yard line.
JaMychal Finley in motion. First and goal from the Buffalo 8. Rodgers to Brandon Jackson. Jackson pushes the pile close to the 5. He's brought down to the 6-yard line. Really, Randy, that's the difference between a good team in the NFL and a team trying to rebuild. When you have momentum going and then you throw the pick, you turn it over, and now you put your defense on a short field and at a huge disadvantage.
And it's a self-inflicted error. It's not one that a great defense forced you into. You just didn't catch the ball, and now you set yourself up. Watch JerMichael Finley, number 88. I would love in this situation to get him one-on-one and put a ball up and let Aaron Rodgers find a way to get it to him. If you're a coach, that's perfect.
Donald Lee, the backup tight end, is in. With a pump fake, and then Rodgers completes to Lee. Matthew Mann out of Mississippi State. Brought down right after the catch, and Lee loses 2 yards. And takes a pretty good shot.
It's an interesting play, isn't it? Just kind of an underneath, here, you take it, I don't want it. Oh, by the way, you're going to take a hit, too, in the process. But it's a completion.
Kyle Williams makes the tackle. The Bills starter with the nose position. He was called for 2 false start penalties in the first half. 3rd and goal from the Buffalo 8. Buffalo coming with the blitz. Rodgers hit as he throws. It's caught. Touchdown, Packers. It's Donald Driver from 8 yards out.
When you're talking about quarterback pressure, there's pressure you don't want to see, and there's pressure you'll live with. Chris Kelce coming free. Aaron Rodgers knew he was free, held it to the last second, and drilled the back shoulder throw right to Donald Driver for 6.
Driver's 2nd touchdown reception of the young season as Mason Crosby boots the point after through the uprights. Green Bay goes 7 plays, 39 yards after the chiller pick, and their lead is 13.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. Burger King, who reminds you to have it your way. And by Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
Well, the Packers faithful jump into the beat here at Lambeau Field. 20-7, they're Packers in front of the Buffalo Bills with 8:32 to play in quarter number 3. Spiro Dedis, Randy Cross, our entire CBS crew from Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. This is C.J. Spiller from his own 1-yard line. Spiller again showing the burst on the sideline. It was brought down at the Buffalo 28-yard line, a return of 27 yards. So Edwards will get another shot when we come back. Donald Driver, the Lambeau Leaf here in Green Bay. Timeout. Well, Green Bay, the short field after the interception thrown by Trent Edwards. 7 plays, 39 yards, and Donald Driver, a 7-yard touchdown reception from Aaron Rodgers to give Green Bay the 20-7 lead. 8:26 to play, 3rd quarter from Lambeau Field. Marshawn Lynch on 1st down, out past the 30, and down to the 32-yard line.
See, the main problem that Green Bay had in that 2nd quarter is we talked earlier about the personnel they were trying to play with, the 2 defensive linemen and the 2 outside linebackers, and they couldn't hold up in that 2nd quarter to the running game. Right now they have the same package, but in these last 2 possessions, they've done a much better job of getting off those blocks and making the tackles and not cooperating and giving those running yards up.
Well, Dom Capers having to deal with some early injuries. Justin Harrell, one of their defensive linemen, lost for the year. As Edwards is brought down again, it's Clay Matthews for his 2nd sack of the day and his 5th of the season.
Well, Clay Matthews, when he makes these big defensive plays, he does have kind of an ulterior motive. He's a big fantasy football guy, we found out on
Friday.
Yes,
he is.
Who loves to play the Packer defense, by the way. Matthews, anytime you get a big play, it's a couple points for Clay's team.
Matthews had a great story after the game last weekend in Philly. Went home, went on the computer, and there's his dad, Clay Jr. found out that Kevin Cobb is on his dad's fantasy team. And Matthews, of course, knocked him out of the game last weekend, so he and his brothers had some fun with Pop. Did some damage to dad's fantasy team, and it looks like the Bills will have to burn a timeout.
He's wearing his kid's 52. He's not wearing his Cleveland Browns 57? Oh, come on.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by the Dodge Challenger. Visit your local Dodge dealer today. And by Prudential, the rock you can rely on to meet today's financial challenges.
Well, you need a full day to check out the Packers Hall of Fame inside Lambeau Field. Right now, their focus is on the football field. The Packers in a third and long defensively, trying to slow down Tre'Davious Edwards in the offense. Edwards, the little bubble screen to Spiller. Spiller, not much room to go. Forced out of bounds at the 23-yard line. The fumble coming after he was out. And Buffalo will be forced to punt after Spiller picks up just 3 yards.
You see that Hall of Fame here at Lambeau Field. It used to be across the street when they did the expansion and the renovation here. They moved everything inside the building. And a day for the Hall of Fame, yeah, but you'd almost need 2 days for fans. And they treat this place like a tourist attraction. They are everywhere. And they've really built things here to customize to all NFL fans, because this is one of those stadiums, Spiro, I think every fan should get a chance to see a game.
Well, if you're a football fan, this is your pilgrimage coming to Lambeau Field. As Mormon punts it away on fourth down, it's fielded by Tremont Williams. Little cutback maneuver. And then Williams loses his footing at the 35-yard line. And that's where the Packers will take over. 48 yards in the punt. And Williams brings it back for 6 yards. Well, it's alumni weekend here at Lambeau, and the Cheeseheads are soaking it all in. Green Bay, a 20-7 lead. Here in Green Bay, 6 and change left to play in quarter number 3. The Packers back in possession, leading Buffalo 20-7. Alongside Randy Cross, I'm Spiro Dinas, our entire CBS network crew with you from Lambeau Field here on alumni weekend. John Kuhn lines up at the running back position. Of course, no Ryan Grant, done for the year. So far, they have not felt his absence on this day as Kuhn is out past the 40. And you hear the chants of Kuhn from 60,000 plus. Well, it's not too late to play NFL.com's all-new fantasy football game, the first and only game with video. It's free and easy to play. Sign up today at NFL.com/fantasy.
Well, Spiro, you talked about, we both talked about what a great place this is. There is one thing about this place that is real throwback.
What's that?
The metal bench seats.
Yes, the bleachers. No seat backs. None of that cushiony, pillowy stuff that they're used to at some of the new venues around the NFL. Rodgers goes play action on second and short. Finding Jordy Nelson inside Buffalo territory. He's got a first down, down to the 42 as Green Bay picks up 15 yards.
That was a beautiful job by Jordy Nelson driving the corner off. Watch this matchup right here on the bottom. And when Jordy Nelson gets to the top of his route, look at the separation he creates. Puts the brakes on. That's like 10 yards. You got to close that down. Can't get beat deep, but you got to close that down. Nice move by Nelson.
And Nelson, Randy's going to have to pick his spots now at the wide receiver position because he's got more special teams responsibilities with Grant on the shelf. Rodgers completes to the tight end, Finley. Such a big target for Rodgers as Finley lowers his shoulders and barrels his way to the 19-yard line. They pick up another 22 yards.
That looks like a mismatch with Dante Whitner. JerMichael Finley coming from the left side of the deep offense, crossing all the way across. Whitner trailing him. It's a mismatch. It's like having, you know, Steve Nash guard Shaquille O'Neal inside. There's such a huge difference in size.
That's a bit ambitious for George Edwards. Whitner just 5'10". Trying to stay with that guy, JerMichael Finley. Finley listed at 6'5", 247. Rodgers hands to Kuhn inside the 20, close to the 17-yard line after he picks up 3 yards. So again, it all goes back to the Tre'Davious Edwards interception. The Packers had seen their lead cut to 13-7. Edwards trying to find his wideout, Steve Johnson, early in this third quarter, right through Johnson's hands. And now Green Bay, like the good football team that they are, Super Bowl contender, taking full advantage.
This is like a really good boxer, Spiro. He's got you softened up. And this drive is very much looking to hit you on the button, put you asleep for a while.
Jackson in motion on second and seven. Rodgers pressured up the middle. Lofting to Jackson. Inside the 10, down to the 7. And now this vaunted passing attack really starting to pick up steam. Jackson goes 10 yards.
Well, if there's two things you can't teach a quarterback. One is accuracy. They're either accurate or they're not. And the other thing is the ability to make plays like this. I don't care if you qualify the guy as a pocket passer or a run type or whatever. There are a limited number of quarterbacks that can get out of the pocket going the wrong way and make that kind of play.
Well, you had a guy who was pretty good at that to learn from 3 years on the bench playing behind Brett Favre.
But he shall be he wasn't going to be named.
Rodgers completing again, and it squirts out of the hands of James Jones. Jackson able to fall on in a 10. As the clock will continue to run down to 2:37 left to this third quarter.
That was a nice job of finishing off Jones and popping that ball loose, because it was a fumble.
James Jones, the fourth-year man from San Jose State. Packers drafted him in the third round of 2007. Now, Rodgers says that Jones on most other teams in the NFL would be a top one or two receiver. Here he's number three. Second and goal for Green Bay. Rodgers again has time. Runs it himself, and he's into the end zone. And the quarterback takes his turn at the Lambeau leap.
Now you're gonna get him official leap on that, right?
It was a half-hearted attempt.
An attempted leap.
I think they helped pick him up. Got about halfway up the wall, and then they lifted him up.
Looked like me trying to jam a basketball on an 8-foot basket. Not quite, but great, great nimble move by Aaron Rodgers. And his receivers did the perfect thing. When he broke the contain, they ran to the backside of the end zone. That drug the entire defense with him.
Rodgers from 9 yards out. Mason Crosby's extra point is good. And suddenly Green Bay has a 20-point lead.
Now watch the defense go with the receivers. As the receivers react, they go to the back of the end zone. And by taking the defenders with them into the end zone and towards the back of the end zone, that opens things clear for Rodgers. And he's still got the scoots to get there.
I don't know if that one fan is offering Aaron a beer at the end of this leap. He's holding him up with one arm. He's got his beer in his left hand. Aaron says, let me get out of here before something happens. As Trent Edwards looks on, boy, frustrating for the Buffalo quarterback and their offense.
And remember, he has seen Aaron Rodgers for a while. Not only are they both California guys, Edwards is from Los Gatos. Edwards went to Stanford. Aaron went to, he's from Chico. He went to Cal. They're familiar.
Chico about a 70-mile drive from Sacramento as you see Rodgers. Talked about the run game for Buffalo in the first half, and now slowly but surely the three-headed monster with Aaron Rodgers starting to influence this game.
See, they're not giving him a bad, I guarantee you they're not giving him a bad time about the run. They're giving him a bad time about the jump, the attempted leap. But when your quarterback shows up in the rushing stats and he's a thrower, that's not a good sign for a defense.
Green Bay, 7 plays, 64 yards in just 4 minutes and 24 seconds. This is C.J. Spiller. Spiller trying to break one. Spinning up past the 35, up to the 37-yard line. So Spiller, a return of 36 yards. And once again, we'll give Edwards some decent field position. Coming this fall to CBS, get ready to catch the wave. Hawaii 5-0. It premieres tomorrow, only CBS.
Great music, great islands, and they're keeping the book 'em Dano.
Well, the great scenery in the background. Finally, the highly anticipated premiere comes your way tomorrow night. Buffalo desperately needing some offense here. They're down 20 with a 1:47 left in this third quarter.
You got plenty of time. Just don't get impatient. If you do, this could get ugly.
This is Marshawn Lynch on first down. He's close to the 40 and brought down at the Buffalo 41-yard line. Brady Papinga, the backup outside linebacker out of BYU, making the tackle after Lynch picks up 3 yards.
You know, in the NFL, when you go through an offseason, the last thing people remember about you is what they saw last. And for this Packer defense, as great a year as they had under Dom Capers last year, people remember that playoff game against Phoenix where Arizona Cardinals just gashed them. They were number two in the league in total defense.
Green Bay giving up 51 yards in that wild card matchup. Certainly the lasting image that they were not looking for as Lynch picks up a couple of more yards on second down. It'll set up a third and long here for Trent Edwards. Lynch picks up 3 more.
That's at least kind of a medium. You know, the 3rd and 18s, the 3rd and 10s, the 3rd and 12s.
This is manageable.
Last week, that's what Buffalo was getting killed with. His first down was either 0 or -yards the majority of the time of their possessions.
Let's see what Gailey draws up here. Could be the final play of the third quarter. With Buffalo down 20. 3rd and 4 from the 43. Edwards completes to Johnson, atoning for the last incompletion earlier in the quarter that led to the pick. Johnson, a huge first down pickup inside Green Bay territory as they move the chains. It's 15 yards.
I love this. Don't let the guy fester about it. Don't let him worry about it. Just give him a chance to make up for it. You can see on the sideline it bothered him, and beautiful job by Gailey, Edwards, everybody.
As we kick off the fourth quarter, Spiro Dedis, Randy Cross, our entire CBS crew with you from Lambeau Field. Trent Edwards in Buffalo down 20. They had cut a 13-point deficit down to 6 at halftime. But so far, it's been all Green Bay after that Edwards interception. Marshawn Lynch on first down barely gets back to the original line of scrimmage.
Well, can Buffalo do what they did in the first half and the second half? They're going to have to get more passing yards out of Trent Edwards, but Chan Gailey watched his team get dominated in the first quarter, come back and dominate the second. They made a mistake in the third quarter. Green Bay made a pay for them twice with touchdowns, but can they turn the skirts a little bit here? Can they turn things around? Can they dominate in the fourth quarter and get some points on the board?
Buffalo's ground game again has been a non-factor. After they really picked up steam in the second quarter, Parrish is buried in the backfield.
Did he get stripped?
Morgan Burnett makes the stop. The Packers say they have it. Looks like it'll be ruled an incompletion.
Yeah, it's called an incomplete pass. Tell you what, though, it looked like Burnett came in, and as that ball was being caught, it looked like he ripped it right out of his arms.
And now they say Green Bay football.
Watch the contact.
The receiver lost.
Look at Burnett.
The ball on contact.
But the question is, did he even have possession to start?
No, he doesn't have
right,
to.
It was thrown behind the line of scrimmage.
No,
right?
But the ball also wasn't possessed. It was still in the air. Right. It was anybody's ball. It ended up being Burnett's. Morgan Bennett, the rookie out of Georgia Tech. Drafted, he started since day one, and man, is this a nice job. Ball never hits the ground, hits Roscoe Parrish, bounces off his arm, bounces off his knee, bounces off Burnett's chest and on his thigh pad, but never hits the ground.
Talk about living a charmed life. You mentioned the injuries that they've dealt with in the secondary has been filling for Tari Bigby all the way back to OTAs and minicamp in May. So second Buffalo turnover gives it back to Green Bay with a chance to build on a 27-7 lead.
Yeah, well, think about the two big plays in the second half here. Now you got the pick by Burnett, and earlier it was Chiller with his first interception. So it hasn't come from the obvious guys. You look at this defense, you think of, you know, is it going to be Matthews causing a fumble? Is it going to be Woodson getting a pick at the corner?
Unlikely sources of defense today by Green Bay. Now Rodgers, another chance, working from the shotgun on second and 10. And as markers fly, blowing the play dead.
Ball start. Offense number 75. 5-yard penalty. It remains second down.
It's Brian Bulaga. Back up at the left guard position, the rookie out of Iowa.
He's playing left tackle right now for Chad Clifton. And he's got a bright, bright future. In fact, if it was necessary, I'd say it's so bright he should wear shades. But he moved a little bit early. Kelsey sort of lured him a little bit, and he moved.
Packers today, 5 penalties, 44 yards. Second and 15, they spotted at the 43. Rodgers, wobbly throw, incomplete. You rarely see that kind of ball come out of Rodgers' hands cleanly. Intended for Greg Jennings. Thursdays this fall, William Shatner is an outspoken father who tells it like he sees it in the new comedy, Bleep My Dad Says. Thursdays after the Big Bang Theory, only CBS.
To go a little old school on you, seeing some of the promos, it looks like that's Captain Kirk goes Archie Bunker.
Yeah. Ladder Retro. And CBS as the fall schedule comes into effect. Green Bay, 6 of 10 on third down conversions this afternoon. Here's Rodgers again from the shotgun. Rodgers completes, but right at the first down marker. It's Jermichael Finley. And this one will depend on the spot.
Oh, he's got the first down. He caught the ball. He was past the first down marker when he actually caught the ball. He was pushed back.
It's a 15-yard pass play, and they will move the chains.
And the key for that really was the route. If you see Finley's on the right side of your screen, he'll come in right as the ball is thrown. He got to the first down marker, then got pushed back. But that's good discipline by the young tight end, knowing where the sticks are, knowing where the first down yardage is, and going past it and coming back to catch the ball.
Second career game of 100 yards for Jermichael Finley. This is Kuhn. Nice cutback inside the 35. He fumbles. But it looks like Kuhn falls right back onto the football at the 30-yard line as he picks up another Green Bay first down.
You want to see a hole? Well, this hole is going to literally be, we use the term about the A-gaps. It's kind of like outside of the A-gap to A-gap wide. Right here. Look how big that hole is. Spiro, you and I could run through that.
Well, you can.
We wouldn't get the extra yards, but we could run through it.
You can. I can.
Then we'd get lit up.
Well, Buffalo's going to be whistled here for too many men. It looks like late penalty marker, and it's a touchdown regardless. James Jones. As Rodgers throws it again to the back shoulder, a second marker is thrown in the secondary.
Are they going to get James Jones for pushing off on that back shoulder pass? We saw Jennings got away with one earlier.
Yes, he did. Got away with one earlier. Ron Winter is our lead referee.
Because the too many players on the field would be a Green Bay touchdown.
I think we have our answer.
There are two fouls on the play. Illegal substitution, 12 men on the field. Defense, our penalties declined. Offside, defense. That penalty is declined. That results in a touchdown.
No better late than never. Aaron Rodgers to James Jones for the 30-yard touchdown. And it's 33-7 Green Bay.
You know, Spiro, when we talked to Aaron Rodgers Friday, he was clearly not real happy from last week. And he's made up for it today. It hasn't been clean. It hasn't been perfect. But man, has this guy thrown some beautiful passes to his receivers, and they've adjusted extremely well.
21 unanswered points by Green Bay as Crosby's point after is through the uprights. Aaron Rodgers will be a little bit happier with what he's seen here in week two. Timeout.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Loveza, Sony, and by Corona, who invites you to find your beach.
Now the floodgates have opened here in Green Bay. 21 straight points scored by the Packers. James Jones, 30-yard touchdown reception. And that is where we stand, 34-7. Early fourth quarter from Lambeau Field. Mason Crosby on to put it away from his own 30. C.J. Spiller will return from his own 8. Spiller has looked good on kick returns today. Here he is again, finding some open space up the sideline, inside Packers territory, and finally forced out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Well, the Lambeau leaps have been plentiful, certainly since halftime. Brandon Jackson, Donald Driver, and even the quarterback. Timeout. Back with you from Green Bay, Trent Edwards and the Bills offense back under center. Early fourth quarter with Buffalo down 34-7. A combined Roscoe Parrish close to the 30. A rare bright spot in the passing game. Parrish picks up 21 yards. Boy, all the talk about Trent Edwards and how conservative he's been. Randy, I don't care who the quarterback is. If you don't give him time and you drop balls, you're not going anywhere.
Yeah, he hasn't gotten much help. And especially hasn't gotten much help from the Green Bay defense. They've taken Lee Evans almost out of their playbook. And that really limits this offense because there's no one else to really at this point step up and be a difference maker.
Edwards on first and 10 is crushed as he throws. It was batted up out of the air and falls incomplete. Now the bigger story for people who cover this team has been their constant and really annual inability of fielding anything good. Randy, with their offensive line, they just cannot protect the quarterback.
They've struggled. They've drafted some. And I think Chan Gailey, part of the change in culture is taking this team from wishing they'd win to thinking they're going to win. And until you get a chance to do it, until you come back in a big spot, until you have reps and real live fire and you're successful, it doesn't come because somebody tells you it's true.
No significant free agent upgrades from a year ago as Marshawn Lynch is chopped down in the backfield, loses a yard on second down. It'll be third and long. And when you can't give your quarterback time to throw, he's not going to throw for many yards. It's been 4 long years since a Bills quarterback threw for 300 yards in a game. It was J.P. Lossman doing it back in 2006.
And no coincidence that his favorite receiver on that day and his favorite receiver in general when he was starting for the Bills was Lee Evans, especially deep plays down the field. It's 55 games is the streak. Look who's number two, Jets at 51.
Just an amazing streak. Edwards has never thrown for 300-plus in a game. Here he is running, trying to find some open space, nowhere to throw, and he's forced out. And boy, look out, one of the sideline audio people that's bowled over there. They make sure he's okay. As Edwards winds up picking up a yard, well short of the marker, it'll be fourth down and long. Yep.
Now that shows me a little something, our audio guy there on the sideline. That's some toughness.
That is what you call bounce back ability.
He wasn't even going to drop the dish until the last second.
He's got to get his sound first.
Look at Edwards. A little high low. He's got it. He just does lose the dish.
I hope he's okay. Fumble.
Hope he's okay, but
God bless him. Edwards and company going for it on fourth down, and there's a familiar sight. Clay Matthews on the quarterback as Buffalo gives up its sixth sack on the afternoon.
I did a game here a little while back. Vonnie Holiday had 5 sacks in a game. Clay Matthews is doing this at will.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Subway. home of the famous $5 footlong. Subway, where winners eat. And by E-Trade.
Spiro Dinas, Randy Cross back with you from Lambeau Field. 34-7 Packers. They're on cruise control here. Well, it's been all Clay Matthews defensively for the Packers. He shattered the NFL rookie mark a year ago with 10 sacks. And Randy, he's going for the all-time mark. He's got 6 sacks this season, another 3 today, and he's done it in 7.5 quarters.
Well, he had a good week of practice because he picked up that extra sack on Tuesday. Was his third from the last week, but there's no doubt they're not going to need any rulings on this one. And it was him that hit Trent Edwards on that play where the ball popped up in the air. He was the one that knocked the crud out of Trent Edwards and caused that ball to come out of it.
Well, he has got a motor that just does not turn off playing in front of his father
Ball
today.
Start.
He's in the seats.
Offense number 23. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Imagine playing against that defense a couple years ago at USC. Because you had Brian Cushing on one side.
That's right.
You had Clay Matthews. You had Ray Malaluga in the middle. You had Ellis at defensive tackle. I mean, this group is scary. And Clay Matthews right there in the 52 jersey. Old dad's a proud father and was also one heck of a linebacker for about 2 decades himself for the Cleveland Browns.
Matthews with the football pedigree. His father, his grandfather played 4 years in the league. And, of course, his uncle Bruce Matthews, the 14-time NFL Pro Bowler. Rodgers with another first down completion, this time to Greg Jennings. Inside Buffalo territory, they pick up 21 yards.
Aaron Rodgers himself is crawling up towards a 300-yard day, and he's doing it with wonderful protection. The defense has to respect any kind of a run fake because they have been able to run the ball at least moderately well, and his accuracy has been really impressive. Mike McCarthy's going to like what he sees when he looks at the tape of this one.
Clock continues to run. 8 minutes left and counting. Oh, we mentioned the drought for Buffalo's quarterbacks. 55 straight games without 300 yards. Here is the other side of the coin. During that span, here's what the other elite quarterbacks have done in the NFL. Breeze has done it 24 times. Rodgers, you see at the bottom of your picture, 9 such games.
So you're saying it can be done?
Yes. Okay. Apparently it can be done around the NFL, but these guys have pretty good offensive lines in front of them. That really is the one constant. It's certainly something that the Bills have not had.
You see there in the stats below the score, Aaron Rodgers, 45 yards from adding to that 9 list.
Jackson inches closer to the 37. And right now we send it to New York in an update in JB.
Spiro, check this sequence. Brett Favre throws a pick. Miami gets the ball. They fumble. Then Minnesota trailing by 4. Fourth and goal under 1. And Adrian Peterson hit first by Carlos Dansby. That Dolphin stout defense stops him there at the goal line. Miami nursing a 4-point lead. That with 2:06 left in regulation. Back to Spiro and Randy.
Well, JB, thanks. Some interesting scores around the NFL, the early games. As the Miami Dolphins very close to winning a second straight game atop the AFC East. This is Rodgers rolling out. Rodgers' pass is batted down at the 25-yard line by Jairus Byrd.
And to fans of this NFC North, Minnesota getting off to an 0-2 start, losing that opener to the New Orleans Saints. Brett Favre, all that drama that's been around him the last 3 or 4 years. Maybe they should have paid a little bit less attention to Brett and more attention to details in Minnesota, get off to a better start.
Rodgers and company will have to punt. This Green Bay team that had their postseason run ended in that NFL Classic, the wild card game in Arizona, 51-45 in overtime. But the Packers team that turned in one of its best statistical seasons ever in 2009, trying to build on that. Unable to down the punt inside the 5. It'll be a touchback for Buffalo. But as Randy mentioned, certainly buoyed by what could be an 0-2 start by Minnesota. And the chance to pat on their lead early in the season. So Saturday, the Home Depot SEC on CBS looks out for number one as Heisman winner Mark Ingram and the top-ranked Crimson Tide tangle with Ryan Mallette and the Razorbacks. It all starts with the TIAA Crep College Football today.
How about that comeback by Ryan Mallette in Arkansas at Athens? Dogs came back and tied him, and then Mallette, with about 15 seconds to go, hit Childs for that touchdown. It's going to be a great matchup. Alabama, I don't know if Alabama can be beaten.
Mallette, one of the stars they'll look for in that game. Is Buffalo just trying to make it interesting here. As we come up on 6 minutes remaining, Fred Jackson close to the 25-yard line, brought down at the 24, picking up 5 yards.
You talk about college again real quick. How about Mark? How about Ingram yesterday?
He misses a couple. I think he's back healthy from the injury, his first play from scrimmage.
9 carries for 100 and something. I mean, he had an unbelievable day against Duke yesterday, but his replacement, Trent Richardson, is really something special. And, gee, their quarterback, he's just never lost a game as a starter, that's all.
That's not fair. Alabama against Duke. That game was over before it started. This is Edwards again on the ground. Slides out past the first down marker, getting up to the 32-yard line. Edwards picks up 7. It'll be 1st and 10 for Buffalo.
These last couple of pass plays that Buffalo has run are a pretty good example of what Chan Gailey's football team has been looking at for the better part of today, because the receivers down the field look like they've got a green and gold jersey velcroed to them. None of them are getting clear.
Chan Gailey's got his work cut out for him with this Buffalo team. Mentioned just 6 wins a year ago. This is Jonathan Stuper, the tight end, second year man from Virginia. Picks up 5 yards on first down. Buffalo's postseason drought, 10 years, the longest such drought in the 50-year history of the franchise.
And the biggest challenge to me, and we talked a little bit about that, having to do it just because somebody tells you, it doesn't make it so, but they've had so many over the last couple of years, yeah, but games. And they'll tell you about it. Yeah, but, you know, we played so-and-so, we were right there. Yeah, but we almost put so-and-so. Those have got to be complete. You've got to finish people like that off.
Jackson on first down takes a hard hit. Out of bounds close to the 50-yard line. A couple of games that they should have won right in that category. You know, last season, probably should have beaten New England, Randy. They had Dallas in another game. Well, you find a way to win those games. All of a sudden, you're a 500 team.
And the key, having been on bad teams, too, when a coach tells you something, then you actually do it, then you really believe it. You see what's happened so far. You know, the total offense, 328 yards in 2 weeks. That's not going to beat anybody. Sorry.
Blaine Matthews just continues his dream start to 2010. As Buffalo loses yardage on first down.
And the scary thing about this kid and this defense is they're just learning Dom Capers' 3-4. You know, this defense right now is the definition of that old, you always see the martial arts movie, and the sensei says, well, you know, I've taught you everything you know. I just haven't taught you everything I know. Well, Dom Capers is that teacher. And those guys are doing what he's allowed them to learn so far. They're looking beautiful, but there's so much more in Dom Capers' defensive playbook.
Dom Capers, 25 years in the NFL. Edwards completes to Johnson. Inside Packers territory, about 2 yards short of the marker at the 44-yard line.
Yeah, Dom came into the NFL with Jim Mora from the Philadelphia Stars in the old USFL days, and they went down to New Orleans. And Ricky Jackson, one of his old linebackers, went in the Hall of Fame this year, along with Jerry Rice, an old teammate of mine. And I tell you, Dom has had some dominant defensive players, but has had a run of defensive linemen and linebackers. I'd match that resume up with about any defensive coach out there.
Well, you ask him, they got Clay Matthews and some of the young studs on his defense. His eyes just light up. So excited about how good this Green Bay defense can be. And again, it's going to take some time to put out the bad taste that was left in their mouths following that 51-45 playoff loss in Arizona. But they're certainly a good start. They went into Philadelphia, a hard-fought win. A stadium that is very, very tough to win it. In fact, it was their first win in Philly in 48 years, Randy. The last time they won in that city Their head coach was named Vince Lombardi. Look at some of the games coming up next. The Jets-Patriots, one of the marquee matchups in week number two. This is C.J. Spiller. Trying to get some run late in this game. See a helmet come flying off. Ryan Pickett. The defensive end on the stop after Spiller picks up 3 yards.
You know, Clay Matthews comes back into the game in an obvious passing situation, hopefully, for them. But, you know, I want to say one thing here. There's a coach on the Green Bay staff that Matthews has done a great job and gotten some great things from. Kevin Green, old Rams, Steeler. He has learned wonders from Kevin Green and shows it.
No, Randy just alluded to Clay Matthews, the stud linebacker. He's had a chance to learn from Kevin Green, a man who posted 160 career sacks over a career spanning with four different teams.
As good a pass rusher in my era, in my mind. As good a pass rusher as anybody.
Now, speaking of sacks, Edwards out of the grasp for a moment, gets it off and finds Parrish. He was brought down at the 31 marker. His fly. And we'll see what the call is here. It was C.J. Wilson applying the pressure.
That's what happens when offensive linemen try to tackle the defensive lineman to protect their quarterback.
Not good is what you're saying.
Well, holding. If you're the quarterback, it's a good
offense
thing because then nobody's
70.
Hitting you hard enough.
10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Well, plenty more football coming your way later this afternoon. Tom Brady and the Patriots at the Meadowlands in New Jersey to take on Darrelle Revis and the Jets. Texans battling the Redskins or the Jaguars and the Chargers.
Well, for an offseason full of how great the Jets were going to be, yeah, there's suddenly a dearth of quarterbacks in the AFC East. Tom Brady right now is kind of standing alone. Penny looks like a young quarterback. Edwards looks like a young quarterback. Goodness knows Sanchez looks like a young quarterback.
Well, the NFL is a humbling league. The Jets trying to avoid an 0-2 start. Edwards hit as he throws again, finding Spiller. And Spiller takes a wallop at the 43-yard line by Nick Barnett. Boy, Barnett has been all over the field. He's got 7 tackles today.
See, part of the reason you're not throwing every single down is that right there. You're going to expose your quarterback to unnecessary shots. I mean, you're down. You're not going to, there's no such thing as a 27-point play.
So Randy, you bring up a good point. If you're a Bills fan at home, you're probably wondering, hey, we're down big. Let's take some shots. Let's get the passing game going. But Chan Gailey obviously wants to protect his young quarterback.
And just protect the confidence of this offense in general. Because pass protection against this style of a defense, when you get in this situation, there is no mercy. There's no mercy rule in the NFL. Lee Evans got that long pass interference penalty called against Charles Woodson, but otherwise complete non-factor. They threw an O-for at him.
Well, Gailey says, why not? On 4th and 11, Edwards standing right at midfield. Rolling left, he'll have to throw across his body and won't even take a chance.
There was nowhere to go. There was no one open. 0 receivers were open. I mean, if you watch down the field, let it run a little bit further, and you'll see what Trent Edwards saw. Okay, now stop it right there. Now, that's covered. That's covered. You know, it's just, you're not going to throw it there. I mean, there's nowhere. They were trying to protect their young quarterback, sending some receivers out into the pattern. But half the guys that look like they might be open are surrounded by defensive players, Spiro, that are just begging you to please throw it. I'll intercept it.
Edwards will fall to 14-18 as an NFL starter. Just did not have much help here in Green Bay today. Buffalo will go to 0-2, the Packers to 2-0.
Another frustrating day for C.J. Spiller. He had some nice flashes on some of those returns. But aside from that little flip out of the backfield, there weren't many spaces for him to use that speed in.
Packers will win a third straight home opener under Mike McCarthy. Make it a fourth straight after this win today. So alumni weekend, a success here at Lambeau Field. Aaron Rodgers and company, a slow start, had their 13-point first-half lead cut to 6 at the break. With a Trent Edwards interception through the hands of his wide receiver, Steve Johnson, breathing new life into the pack. And they never look back.
Yeah, the problems that Buffalo had, they created the positives in the second quarter, and they created all the negatives in the second half.
Your final score this afternoon from Green Bay, the Packers 34, the Buffalo Bills 7. Coming up next, game 2 of our NFL doubleheader. So for Randy Cross, this is Spiro Dinas saying so long from Green Bay. You've been watching the NFL on CBS. Coming up, it's the Burger King update. We'll take you to New York for all of the scores and highlights after this.